when they have their varicose veins stripped and tied, find that they come back in the future. How can this be if they've been surgically removed?
Well, tying and stripping, of course, is a traditional way of doing varicose veins, and we've known for years that's what causes them to come back. It stems from the 1890s when really the father of varicose vein surgery, a man called Trendelenburg, found that varicose veins were caused because the veins were varicose, they'd lost their valves. And he decided that as the valves had gone, the blood must flow the wrong way. And by tying that vein off, and then other people afterwards showed that you then, by removing it as well, you can stop the blood falling down the legs, and you can cure the varicose veins. The problem was, and what they didn't realise, was that by causing this damage, the cutting, the stripping, the tying, you were stimulating the body into just regrowing the back. The body didn't know it had surgery, it thought it was just being damaged, or maybe being bitten or something. So you get this regrowth back, and in 2005 at the Whiteley Clinic, we showed that this happens in 23% of people in 1 year. We've also shown that at 5 years, 82% of people regrow their veins back if you have stripping. Therefore, nowadays what we do is we don't remove the vein at all, we kill it where it is. So we use endovenous laser, we use foam sclerotherapy, we use radiofrequency, depending on the size and shape of the vein. We kill the vein inside the body, tricking the body into eating it away. And of course, once the body has eaten it away as dead tissue, it never comes back again.